Hello, I'm Sophia Murphy from the Solidworks training team. This video introduces a design project using X-Design to model, build, and fabricate a modular marble run. This project provides an opportunity to hone your CAD skills while designing a physical product that's easy to make with a basic 3D printer. The modular marble run allows for endless creativity and exploration of physics concepts, even after fabrication. Marbles are toys that have inspired countless games and innovations dating back to ancient civilizations. Today, marble runs are a common outlet for innovation and creativity among students and engineers alike. The key aspects of this design that I will focus on are design intent, modular design, assembly in CAD, component features, exporting components, and 3D printing. This project uses basic CAD techniques and explores more complicated modular design principles, making it a perfect challenge for beginners while leaving plenty of room for intermediate designers to push the project further. The pieces snap together easily and require no adhesives or fasteners. All of the components are designed with 3D printing in mind to reduce cost and environmental impact. Modular design is a design approach where complex systems are split into smaller parts, or modules, that can be easily connected. The modular design approach is followed in this project to allow for easy rearrangement of components, increasing the longevity and reusability of the project. Additionally, this approach decreases waste during manufacturing, because adjustments only require the refabrication of a single component, rather than the entire project. Let's start by going over how the model is put together in an X-Design assembly. Then, in the sections that follow, I will explain important features of each individual component. To create the assembly, I started by creating sub-assemblies of common component pairings. This reduces repetitive mating, since they'll be reused often. Then, I created sub-assemblies of the towers for the desired track design. This helps simplify the main assembly. In the main assembly, I connected each tower with the desired track. This approach allows for sub-assemblies to be reused in various track designs. Using CAD assemblies to plan the marble run is very valuable to determine how many components need to be fabricated for any given design. Now, let's discuss the individual components. There are three different track types that make up this marble run. The first is the straight track. This track features a flat bottom to make printing easier and reduce support material. Rail ties hold the rails together while minimizing the material used to do so. The distance between the rails is less than the diameter of the marble, so it does not fall through. But the distance is not small enough to increase the risk of the marble falling off the track. Hooks were added to the track to allow for a connection point to the towers that will be easy to attach and detach. The second track type is a sloped track. Many of the features carry over from the straight track. However, since the sloped track can't have a flat bottom, it uses its flat side for printing. The sloped shape is designed to generate momentum, but avoid the marble jumping off the track. Keeping modularity in mind, the overall length of the slope is equal to the length of the straight track, and the overall height is a number divisible by 2 for easier support design. The final track type is a curved track. Once again, many of the features carry over from the previous track components. This track, however, has a taller outside rail to ensure the marble stays on track. A chamfer was added to the ends of the outer rail to allow for a smooth transition between tracks. Since the weight distribution of the curved track can cause it to tilt, a strut is necessary to support it. The design of the support component will inform the design of connector pieces between tracks, so there is much to be considered. Straight edges are necessary for hook and strut connection points. To allow overlapping marble track designs, supports must be able to stack on top of connector pieces, meaning marbles must be able to pass through the supports. This means the width between posts must be wider than the marble diameter and include a cutout that matches the track profile. Smaller extrudes on the top of the support with a matching cut on the bottom allow supports to stack on top of one another. It's important to note that the practical height of the support is shorter than the overall height of the component, since they are stacking on top of one another. The practical height of the support is half the height of the sloped track for easy configuration. Making connectors the same height as the full support would waste material. Creating a support with a practical height half that of a full support is a simple way to allow connectors to be smaller without limiting arrangement possibilities. The straight connector's practical height should be half that of the full support. Connection points should be designed to allow track hooks to easily and securely connect. Strut connections are designed as press fits for increased stability. The top extrude and track cutout is designed to be compatible with the supports. The bottom cut is compatible with supports and features a draft cut to reduce material and eliminate the need for support material when 3D printing. The curved connector has many of the straight connector's features. Additionally, this connector features a banked turn to ensure the marble stays on track. The bank is positioned to ensure the marble has 3 points touching the connector on the turn, rather than just 2. The start and end baskets feature basins to guide the marble to a steady start and stop, respectively. They both need the same connection points as the connectors, and need to be compatible with the supports. They use the same draft angle as the connectors. The final component is the base. This component provides a wider profile to stabilize towers. Its top extrude is compatible with supports, connectors, and baskets. The base also features holes for mounting to a surface if desired. In order to 3D print, the file must be exported in a file type compatible with your 3D printer. This can be done in XDesign through the export feature on the toolbar, or through the Print 3D feature under the Tools tab of the toolbar. When it comes to 3D printing this project, most of the components can be nested easily, and many require supports. Organic supports are recommended to minimize material waste. The supports and sloped track should be oriented on their side to reduce support material and printing times. The remaining components should be oriented base down to reduce support material. Tolerancing before 3D printing is particularly important in modular designs. Designs with perfect fits in CAD often do not fit together when 3D printing, because every printer has a different resolution. Any component interacting with another will likely need to be adjusted. In this project, it's recommended that the bottom cut of each support, connector, and basket is made slightly wider than the top extrudes they stack on top of. Additionally, the strut may need to be designed smaller than the slots on the connectors. This modular marble run project presents endless possibilities for exploration. The individual components are simple enough for beginners to push their knowledge of designing with CAD and provide an in-depth exploration of modular design. The design leaves plenty of room for students to create their own Marble Run components and expand the project. The resulting model also provides a great outlet for exploring physics concepts. The reusability of the modular design makes it more than a one-time use activity. And the project remains sustainable by taking advantage of 3D printing technology while keeping cost and environmental impact low. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to this channel for upcoming projects in the Useful SOLIDWORKS Design Projects You Can Make playlist. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access more content for designing with SOLIDWORKS.